sunshine beating on the good times, moonlight raising from the graves, string band playing more, that honky tonk's pretty young thing going dancing in the rain. Lady spitting at the Nicky Jacks, businessman with a needle and a spoon, coyote chewing on a cigarette, pack of young boys going howling at the moon. Hey darling, sleeping on the blacktop, hey darling, running through the trees, honey, hey darling, leaving for the next town, letting my sense catches up with me. On a number four, two witnesses blowing up high. Not sure whose will be done. You can call me a sinner for wondering why. Hey, darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey, darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey, darling, leaving for the next town. Less of my sense catches up with me. Liquor tastes sweeter in this town. Could it be it's the same as the last? I swear I've seen your face elsewhere before, just as familiar as a bottle and a glass. Hey darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey darling, leaving for the next town. Listen, my sense catches up with me. Hey darling, sleeping on the blacktop. Hey darling, running through the trees, honey. Hey darling, leaving town, less than my sense catches up with me. Less than my sense catches up with me.
Thing ready for the hike. I've got a pair of black diamond hiking poles, fishing rod, small tackle box with everything I'm going to need for the night, chapstick, gold bond, that's essential, some sunscreen, a first aid kit, bear mace, binoculars, knife, emergency fire starter, lighter, flashlight, headlamp, all the cables I'll need, wireless charger. These are the carabiners I'm using. Here's everything for my GoPro. I got a waterproof backing case, a little tripod, selfie stick, and a head mount. Over here for food, I've got two mountain houses, a beef stew, and a breakfast skillet. This is just a bag I've kind of filled with whatever we've got here. It's pepperoni, trail mix, like crackers, and beef jerky. Over here I've got my titanium eating utensils, toilet paper, little bag to store things in, comb, 2 liters of water, a life straw, some extra clothes, a sleeping bag, and an inflatable air mattress, my trusty old hiking hat, and I think that's about it. I gotta fit all this into and on that bag. Alright, it's 12:41 p.m. August 28th, and I'm at the bottom of the trailhead about to start up, so I've got 9 miles till I get to the lake, so it should take me, I'm guessing, somewhere between 4 to 6 hours to get up there. This is my second time going to Ice Lake. This is my first time going up to summit the Matterhorn though, and my first time going up here without a hiking partner. So we'll see how it goes. I will get back to you guys here in a couple miles. So far so good. Just got past the sign, entering the wilderness. or the Eagle Cap Wilderness, White Man Forest. Anyways, so far so good. Quite a few people up here since it's late July or late August, so won't be too lonely climbing up here. But there's an Eagle Cap Wilderness sign. Probably a mile and a half in by now. This is why I come out here, and we still got a long ways to go. Once I cross the river, that's when it really starts getting pretty. I think you guys will like the bridge I have to cross. It's pretty sketchy, but we'll get to that in a little bit. Going pretty good still. Getting pretty close to the bridge. I'd say I've only got like a mile or two till I'm there. Bridge is kind of like my halfway slash, well, it's more like one third of the way there mark. It's also a nice nice place to take a break from hiking around all this stuff. Seen probably more people coming down than going up so far. It just seems like a lot of Portland, Oregon hippies. And that makes sense because of how many Subaru Outbacks I saw with roof racks and little Oregon stickers on them. So far, just a lot of hippies, which is fine. They like to take care of the environment better than a lot of other people that could be walking around up here that don't care about nature. Yeah, so I'll check back a little bit again. Okay, so I made a right turn down the trail. I think it's trail 1808. It's gonna take me down a little ways across a bridge, and then we're gonna start going up fast. It's gonna be really steep. So far I've met a couple nice people though coming up here. Met a dad with two boys on his shoulders carrying them around. Then I spent another father back there with three boys. They were stopping for some food. It's always nice seeing parents bring their kids out and teach them to respect nature and love being outdoors. Met another couple there from somewhere in Europe. I forget where they said, but yeah. They said they live in New York now, but they're over here to hike. And lo behold, here's the bridge. I'm gonna take a bit of a break and then I'll come back and show you guys the bridge. You can cross it and then we'll start going up. All right, so here's our bridge that I was telling you guys about. Right now, it doesn't look too bad, but last year, me and my buddy Taylor came up here in late June. And it was, those mountains up there were still completely white. And it was just starting to heat up. So this river was about up to where this little berm is, up to like this piece of wood. And it was just going. You could hear the water just carrying boulders down, picking them up off the ground and knocking them against other rocks. But yeah, so it's not too bad this time. So we'll go ahead and cross it. And I'll keep recording that so you guys can see what it looks like. Yeah, another fun thing about this bridge is when you're walking across it, not only does it only have one side to catch you, but the entire thing kind of bows under your own weight. Yeah, last time I crossed this though, those rocks were invisible. You could not see them. Yeah, so there's that. It's about to get hard. I'm gonna head up this trail to the left. And you guys can't see right now, but there's a mountain over there and these mountains here. We're gonna go between them a ways. Cut up, we'll get to a meadow. And after that meadow is when it really, really starts getting hard, and it's just straight crossbacks almost all the way up to Ice Lake. a lot of cool people up here. Guys said he was packing in some gear for some hikers. So I don't know if he gets, if that's his job and he gets paid for this, or if he's part of the pack sal station down in Wallowa campground area. So they'll do horseback rides up here. Or maybe he's just friends with whoever's hiking up around here. But yeah, cool guy. We still got a lot of ground to cover. So here we are, starting to get up there a little ways. Yeah, starting to get there. Still making my way through this meadow, one of the two meadows that you cross through getting up to Ice Lake. Yeah, so when I crossed that bridge a little bit ago, I was an hour and 5 minutes since I started hiking. That's about the same amount of time it took for me and my buddy to get there last year. So making pretty good time for having only self-motivation. Yeah, so it's been about 20 minutes since I was at the bridge, so looking at about another 3-4 hours till I'm there. So that's the first thing I've ran into that I don't want to piss off up here, other than maybe some bears or some cougars, but there's four wasps right there tearing up a grasshopper. Yeah, so hopefully I don't step in their nest, because it's going to be a long trip up or down, depending on how badly they sting me. Yeah, here we're going to get into some of the rockier switchbacks. It'll be like this for quite a while, at least till the meadow. Then once you get past the meadow, it's up here a couple more miles, you start running into an area where trees kind of stop growing. By the time you get to the lake, there really, it's only some short bushes and really low growing ground vegetation, along with some high alpine trees. Here we're coming up on our first little peak of Adam Creek, which is the outlet of Ice Lake that we're hiking to. There's about two or three more little stops up here where you can see it better, but this is the start of it. This is where the trail starts getting kind of hellacious and very hard to walk on, but I'll get a little bit of video of me going up this. Show you guys what I'm going to be walking on for about the next mile or so. Yeah, slow going up this stuff. It's easy to slip and fall, or have a rock come out from under you and break your ankle. And I do not want to walk as far as I've walked now back home with a broken ankle. Yeah, this is what I'm going to be up against for quite a while. Here is a better view of Adam Creek. If I had a death wish, I'd go down there and get some water, but I don't really feel like riding a water slide all the way down to the river that flows into Wallowa. Eh. Actually, this, I don't know, let's take a look. Like I was saying, last year, there's a lot more water coming out of all the lakes and rivers. So I might be able to get down here. Yeah, there's a lot of cool rock up here. There's
whatever this is, couldn't tell you, but there's also a lot of this white granite, like right here, all over the place. Yeah, we're starting to get close. I mean, not close, but I can sort of start to see where I'm headed up there at a tree stop. It's getting up around Ice Lake. And I'm gonna stop here and pull out my life straw and have some water so I'm not using up everything in my backpack. Here's a little better view of the waterfalls. There's one of them, and there's the one up there, a little closer to the lake. Here is the meadow, the last one. Beautiful views. You can see where the alpine line kind of tapers off up there, and trees stop growing. Not very much good soil or oxygen up there for anything. But yeah, we're gonna make our way through this. Take some more little clips on my way through it. And then we're gonna start going up really fast. Forget how many feet we gain, but the last like 2 miles around there is just straight switchbacks all the way up to the lake. Makes for some amazing views though. Yeah, we'll get going on that. Yeah, we're getting there. Let's see. I don't know. I'm guessing about a mile or two. I'm pretty bad at distance, but it's kind of hard to tell when you're going zigzag all the way up on these crossbacks. Yeah, but up there you can see on that bottom of that mountain, there's still snow up there, and it's almost September. It's late August right now. So, yeah. It gets cold up here. There's a doe right here. Must be from around the campgrounds where they're a little more tame, because if that was wild, it'd be gone by now. Lake's just up there a little ways more. Checked my phone's GPS, and to my surprise, I had enough coverage, satellite, whatever it is that makes that GPS work its magic. It said I'm getting pretty close to the lake, so it's nice because it's starting to get a little cold. I'm hoping to get up there before the sun sets over the mountains. Do some fishing. If I can't catch myself some dinner, then that's what those mountain houses are for. But I'll probably eat those anyways because I'm starving my ass off, so. Here we are. Ice Lake's just over this little mound. That up there, that big lighter colored hill, that's the Matterhorn. I'll be waking up around 6 to 7 probably tomorrow. I'll start up that. Yeah, but I'll keep recording so you guys can take this in a bit. There's one campground right there. You're a little smarter than I am. I didn't bring a tent. There's the beginning of Adam Creek flowing out of Ice Lake. Yeah, that's it. I'll come back in a bit. I'm gonna go find myself a place to sit down and set up camp, and then I'm gonna cook up some food and fish a little bit. Good news too, because I see some fish out there jumping. In late June when me and my buddy came up here, and it was still, this lake was frozen solid. Came in this little area right here, and I took a nap on those rocks right there for about an hour, then we headed down. I'm not really the greatest at roughing it, but if I can find a spot over there, kind of by where, I don't know if you can see those two people walking around it, I think that's my best bet. So I'm gonna head over there and see if I can't find somewhere to chill for the night. Well, this is looking like home for the night. I'm gonna get all unloaded and get some food going. Blow up my air mattress, my sleeping bag all unrolled. Then maybe try to catch some fish. Don't pass out. Don't pass out. Don't pass out. Call that good. I don't think you guys have any clue in your head how excited I am for this. It says 2 cups. That looks good enough to me. There. Give it a little stir. In case you guys are wondering, this is freeze-dried beef stew. Might not sound appetizing to whoever's watching this, but it sounds like the best thing I could imagine right now. I'm gonna let that sit for a while. I'm gonna get ready to do some fishing. Well, it took me about 4.5 to 5 hours to get here. And I've got just enough sun left for this spinner bait to work while my food finishes cooking. So, hopefully I can catch myself something while I'm here. If not, it's not the end of the world, but I'm sure it would be nice considering I packed in all this extra gear. There's one, finally, there we go. Come on. See what we got. Feels like a pretty good sized brook trout. Okay, maybe not a good sized one, but it fought hard. See if we can pull some more of these out. Oh, it's a little better size. I'm gonna call it good there, because I'm not gonna be able to eat more than 2 of these, plus that big dinner I got made, so. Get this guy put down and then, I can grab the line, and then we'll go cook these up, and I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to do it. Yeah, these are really beautiful fish. And yeah, there we go, pretty red fins. Dots, brook trout, that's what's for dinner. All right, I got these all cleaned up. As you can see, that really red meat. If you haven't had brook trout, it's the best way I can describe it is kind of like a mix between rainbow trout and salmon. And it's probably tied next to kokanee is my favorite fish you can fish out of a lake. Along with my big old bag of goodies, I brought a little bit of seasoning that I'm gonna use on these fish. Close this up so I don't attract nothing that wants to eat my food and me. But so this is just ground black pepper, garlic salt, and dill. You can use whatever you want on these fish, but this is what I prefer. And it's simple. So, fortunately, unfortunately, this pan's a little small, so keep me from eating any raw fish while we're up here. I'm gonna hack off their tails. Then I'm gonna dispose of this everything that when I'm done, all the bones and extra pieces. That'll happen. I'm gonna get rid of all the extra stuff, put it somewhere, bury it maybe a little ways away from my camp, so I'm not worried about nothing crawling up to me when I'm sleeping and trying to eat my food. I'm gonna go wash this off, then I'll be back and I'll show you how I season and cook them. If you don't know already, these are about the slimiest. They're the hardest to hold on to fish. They taste good, but they're super slippery. They don't have any scales. So they just kind of slide around. They're hard to deal with and they're flopping around, but yeah. So, turn this on. Pretty low because char them. So take this, open this up, give it a shake. I'm gonna come over here, just grab a pinch of this, put some inside, a little bit on the outside, and just toss it in. I got a little impatient, so I'm digging into this right now while these fish keep cooking. It's gonna be a little bit till they're done still, but yeah, this stuff, it's not the best food in the world, but it sure as hell works and it tastes still pretty good, especially after 9 miles. When you lose all patience and you finish your other food and you're waiting for the fish to get done, you just go get some water out of the lake, pour a little bit in the pan, and then turn the stove way up higher than it probably should be and just steam them the rest of the way. Smells good. Oh, the fish turned out pretty good. It's not the best looking, but it tastes good. And it'll give me a little bit more energy for tomorrow morning. So, yeah. Also, I've been working on grabbing some wood. Looks like somebody that has been long gone left their pile of decently seasoned, chopped up firewood. So now I'm just looking for kindling and some tinder. It's supposed to get down to about 34 degrees tonight, said at the lake up at the mountain. It was 18 degrees last night, and over here down at the lake, it was 24 degrees, I believe. So it's gonna get pretty cold. So my neighbor doesn't know I've been watching him. He's got a better idea than I had. Looking around on the ground for decent sized sticks, but they all seem to be pretty wet. But I found this dead tree. Let's see if I can't find some branches that are really dry on the ground next to it. If not, steal one off of it. Or find another tree like those ones over there. Perfect. Or that one. Well, I found a bunch of decent wood and a bungee. So it's a good night. Awesome. And there's some more. And some more. Now we're good. I now regret camping where I put my camp spot, but I'm too lazy to move everything over here, so I'm just gonna pretend I didn't see that and keep walking. So, kind of gotten stuff figured out a little bit better now. I originally had no idea how to get up to the Matterhorn. I had a screenshot from online of a general description. Basically, they'll just said walk along the north side of the lake and you'll come to like a meadow or something like that. Take a right, you'll find a foot trail. It's kind of hard to see. So I walked around and there's probably 10 or less people at the lake right now, and I found guy named Art and a lady named Mac, and I talked to them for a bit, and then they didn't know how to get up there, so I went and walked around some more, and I found a guy named Kale that explained it to me. He'd been up there a couple times, and yeah, so I got that figured out now, and I found some other partners, and I forgot the names, but at this point, it doesn't really matter because the way that you gotta climb up is pretty sketchy, and I decided that I'd find somebody else, some other people to climb up with because I didn't feel like falling off and dying and nobody else knowing. So, yeah, I've got a 20-something-year-old guy and a 20-something-year-old lady. I'm horrible with names and I forgot it already, but they're gonna go up with me. I'm gonna wake up at like 5:30, hit the trail at 6, start climbing. Big middle one, that's Matterhorn, that's what we're climbing. The one next to it, way up there, that's Sacagawea Peak. Sacagawea Peak is 11 feet higher than the Matterhorn and is the tallest mountain in the Eagle Cap Wilderness at like almost 10,000 feet. And for the longest time, they thought that the Matterhorn was the tallest one, but then they finally remeasured and it turned out not being. So yeah, I think I'm gonna save the hike between the two ridges to the Sacagawea Peak for when I have my buddy Taylor up here, so that we have a reason to come back up for something that I haven't already done before. Yeah, so I'm gonna call it good. Might get my fire going and go to bed. Try to, at least. It's pretty cold out already. It's supposed to get down to like 34 tonight. Yeah. But wish me luck. Hey guys, so I'm pretty happy with myself. I got one going. Took me a while because there's really nothing. There's really nothing around here for tinder, so kind of just had to hold a ladder up to some small twigs until they finally went. But it up here, it didn't rain. It snowed the past 2 days, and it's August 28th right now, and all the snow's melted, but everything on the ground is pretty wet, so yeah, pretty proud of myself. Yeah, I'm gonna hit the hay and probably go through my videos and delete what I don't need so I have enough footage or room for footage of climbing up the Matterhorn tomorrow. See you guys. So that was a pretty garbage night of sleep. It's 5 a.m. and the sun's slowly starting to come back up. I'm gonna heat up some food and wait for my hiking partners that I found to wake up to and get my stuff put away and grab what I need to hike the mountain and get going on that. And I'm gonna head home after all that's done. Yeah, I'm gonna save most of the space left on my SD card right now, so just for the mountain and up at the top of the mountain. So, yeah, probably won't be filming a whole lot from now until the end of the hike. See ya. Well, the hiking partners didn't work out. I said 6 a.m. I waited for about 20 minutes, and I just decided they weren't gonna wake up, and I came up here to climb a mountain, so I'm at the base of the mountain now. Let's start going up. It's gonna be one hell of a climb. The hardest part about climbing up shit like this when you're at a high elevation is you can only go so far. You need to stop because you're about to explode. You're running out of air. Yeah, we still got a long ways to go, but we'll get there. Been about a half hour now since I started down there, and we're getting there. Still got to get up to that mountain, but yeah, we're getting there. Altitude's starting to get to me a little bit, but a little upset stomach ain't too bad. Yeah, I figure I'd stop here for a bit before I go up there. Shit's starting to get real. Still gotta go up that. And a little bit more stuff like that. I'm not sure what's after that though, but we'll get to that. We'll climb it. Took me 2 hours, a little bit less than 2 hours. We're on top of the Matterhorn. Nice lake down there. You can see Hell's Canyon way out there. Pretty sure I'm looking at Mount Howard. Right over there, I think I can see where the tram stops. Been up here for about 10-20 minutes now, and it's freezing cold. I miss my mom and sister and my dog. I miss regular food and beer, and I miss my friends. So I'm gonna put the GoPro away. I'm gonna climb back down this, hopefully safe and sound. All right guys, took a wrong turn, so my trail's way over there, but I don't want to hike back up that. So trick I saw one time, also that I have observed from over there. Ugh. Not gonna need my stick I found anymore. Okay. Pick a line. Pick a line. Let's see. Go this way. Who needs trails? Not me. Ah, break time. Okay. That's enough break. Oh, I see two people watching me. Like, what the fuck is that guy doing? What an idiot. A little faster than climbing all the way around. This is something I've needed. 2017. Another one about 3-4 feet away from that other penny, but I think I'll save some luck for somebody going up that way. They might need it too. Figure I'd stop at this pretty rock. I'm headed down still. I'm almost there. I'm gonna fill up my pack, go back over to there, get my stuff and head out.
Hey there, you guys. It's been about a week since I got back from my vacation now. About a week and a half since I came home from the hike, or got back to where we were staying from the hike. I figured I'd talk about like the elevation change and the miles that I hiked. Yeah, so here we go. The distance from Willow Lake to Ice Lake is 15.4 miles with round trip. It's kind of weird though, because on all the signs going up there it says it's 9 miles, so I don't really know if it's like 18 miles or 15.4 miles like it says online. But the elevation gain is 3,380 feet and the high point once you get to Ice Lake is 7,900 feet. Once you hike up the Matterhorn, the round trip distance is 3.6 miles. The elevation gain is 1,980 feet and the high point is 9,826 feet. So yeah, it was a good hike. It whooped my ass for sure. It was definitely worth it, and I would recommend going. I plan on going back eventually. So yeah, make sure you guys like, subscribe, comment, and thank you for watching.